One more mass problem. I went ahead and set mine up. I hoped that you had worked ahead so we can check together. When I noticed 100 grams of lead 4 oxide was the given, what we were being asked to solve for were the mass of oxygen. I set up the 3 steps to stoichiometry to divide, ratio, multiply, to work my way from mass of given to mass of want. They even did the hard part for us in this slide and set up the molar mass for us, saving us the addition off the periodic table. When I hit this, I hope you will with me, 100 divided by the molar mass of 239.2 times 1 over 2 times 32, the key sequence through those 3 steps. I hope we reached a common answer, 6.69 grams of oxygen. One more opportunity to practice a mass problem. But in the next step, thinking about limiting reagents. Section 3 asks us, what happens if we want an equation other than from the perfect balanced equation? If we change the balancing, we set up the 2 terms, limiting and excess reagents. For reactions with multiple reactants, it's likely that one of the reactants will be used up completely before the others. And when that reactant is used up, the reaction stops and no more product can be made. That reactant that limits the amount of product is known as the limiting reagent. You'll see me abbreviate that as LR. Limiting reagent or limiting reactant is the one that gets completely consumed and determines how much maximum product we can make. All other reactants that were in excess amounts remain unused have a term excess reactant or excess reagent. The amount of product that can be made from a limiting reactant is called its theoretical yield, the maximum amount produced. In other words, the answer to our stoichiometry problem. In this example, giving a visual of a reaction, methane is a molecule, CH4. Visually, I can see the carbon in the middle and the 4 hydrogens on the outside, giving it a structure, CH4, in a tetrahedral format. I see 2 oxygen molecules. Notice here I have 2 units of O2. When reactants collide, they break their bonds and atoms rearrange to form the products. I have the same number of atoms from the left to right side. I am obeying the law of conservation of mass, but what I've done is just rearrange their order. Carbon dioxide, CO2, is now formed, and 2 units of liquid water. Notice the H and 2 O's, or excuse me, I said that backwards, the O and 2 H's for each of those. A 1:2 to 1:2 stoichiometric ratio. This represents the perfectly balanced equation. Suppose, in the next slide, I think about altering that. Suppose instead of 1 methane, I put 5 methane molecules. And instead of 2 oxygens, I give it 8 oxygen molecules. What is the limiting reagent? What is the maximum amount of product I can make? Well, looking at the stoichiometric ratio, I'm just kind of reading through, it's telling us 8 molecules. Since less CO2 can be made from the oxygen is the limiting reagent. Let's make sense of that. I'm going to rewrite what I have down here just to cover this up a moment so we can find the answer as we discover it together. If CH4 and 2 O2s come out to give me carbon dioxide and 2 waters, the perfect ratio is a 1:2 ratio. It's saying suppose instead of 1 molecule, we start with 5 molecules of CH4. And instead of 2 oxygens, we give 8 molecules of oxygen. What is the limiting reactant? Well, let's think about that in terms of maximum yield. And let's just use the carbon dioxide. If I start with 1 molecule, I produce 1 molecule. That ratio of 1:1. 1 molecule of carbon dioxide will be produced, from every one molecule of methane we start with. Since it's a 1-to-1 ratio, I would expect if I started with 5, I would produce 5, keeping the ratio constant. However, take a look here. If oxygen were the starting point, the ratio has changed. Every one molecule of carbon dioxide forms for 2 molecules of oxygen. When I take the 8 times the ratio of 1/2 of 8 is 4 molecules of carbon dioxide. I can only make as much as the smaller of my two answers. The maximum yield comes from the limiting reagent. There was a vocab word just on the previous slide. It was called the theoretical yield, but I also have used the term maximum yield. Oxygen limits the amount of product. It's called the limiting reagent. It's the smaller of my two answers. Methane, therefore, was the excess reagent. It was not consumed completely in the reaction. We set up a want over given ratio to determine the limiting reactant and relied on stoichiometry to calculate the theoretical, or in other words, the maximum yield. That's what this slide was showing for us, and I just worked it out with you. Let's try that very idea looking at an example in our next practice. How many moles of Si3N can be made? So we're pointing at our product. How many moles? I'm just going to jot that down right here. How many moles? If I start with 1.2 moles of silicon and 1.0 moles of nitrogen, what's the maximum yield? And along the way, we'll have to identify the limiting reagent. Let's start with the first reactant, 1.2 moles of silicon. We'll just set up a want over given ratio where we can target the moles of product, Si3N. Its coefficient goes on top, it's what we want to calculate. 1 mole of Si3N4 is produced from every 3 moles of Si that we start with. The ratio of want over given is 1/3. Well, let's calculate 1/3 of 1.2. I get an answer of 0.4 moles. If silicon is the limiting reagent, 0.4 moles would be the maximum yield. Let's check out the nitrogen and see what it will yield for us. 1.0 moles of nitrogen